Well, hello everyone. Welcome back to the channel. This is the channel, for those of you who don't know, for the official page of Diamond Knight Studios. My name is Cambry. I'm the founder and current chief executive officer. And I wanted to make a switch on our channel. I've been monitoring what people's thoughts are about the podcast lately, and I decided to stick with what I know. So our channel is going to be shifting into doing reviews. The reviews we'll be doing will be over movie soundtracks, and ideally the current ones, whichever ones copyright will allow us to do. But I wanted to start with the new films that are coming out. So to start that new shift in our channel, I wanted to start with a current film that I haven't seen, but I've heard good things about in terms of the story and plot and whatnot. So I'm excited to get into this review. I've already listened to the music, so I have my opinions about the different elements in it. And really, this is designed to for those who are interested in film music and want to not necessarily just talk, but kind of analyze these scores and see what are some of the cool things that these composers are doing in these scores. And for anybody who has any questions about what might be going on behind the scenes in terms of the music and how that music is being made. Just to give you some context, I've started out as a composer in my career, made the shift into production and film and whatnot. So now I'm on a different path, but I have a lot of experience with recording for orchestras, with doing a lot of music production, especially recently. So you can see some of my work that I've had on my page. Of course, I have a lot more in my portfolio. And maybe sometime in the future, I'll share some of those projects that I've worked on. And also just share some tips in terms of whether you have questions about mixing or whether you have any questions about some of the programs or sample libraries or other things that I use. So for those of you who don't know, this channel started out as an audio podcast. We may shift into video at some point, but right now we kind of just want to test out, see what's working for everybody. And we're very sensitive to your feedback. So we're excited to see where this channel goes and as the community grows as well. So thank you for coming. And yeah, again, so we're getting back into the review for the soundtrack of A Quiet Place Day One. Just to say, I'm a big fan of the original movie. I think it has a lot of, it built a groundwork that has a lot of opportunity in terms of storytelling, and music has served its purpose in the first film. And I think it does also that in this film as well. I personally, at the end, will give my rating of the score. And so, you know, that'll just be my personal opinion. Take it as you may. But I think there's a lot to be gained from the score, and I thought it was very interesting. So in the next, as I cue this score up, I just want to let you know the composer is Alexis Grapsas. I do not know this composer. She's actually relatively new, so it's exciting to see a fresh new take. And as I've already heard the music, so I'm excited to get into it. So I will cue this up so we can play and hear the music from A Quiet Place Day One. Thank you. Yeah, so this score is very, very interesting in terms of the sound design. As I was listening to it, I was very curious. It told me a lot about the story without even really me seeing it or needing to see it, in terms of these creatures, what they're like, how they move, how they think. That's an aspect of the storytelling and how music does that. So I think that the score does that very, very well. A lot of it is sound design, as you can tell that noise, that bubbly sound in the beginning. Just for those of you who know music, you'll know that we as musicians often use words like that to describe the sounds we're looking for. So if you hear me say bubbly or squishy or something like that, it's just a means of trying to help you understand what sound I'm talking about. But yeah, so the just to kind of get into that sound design element, to me, what that sounds like, it sounds like the composer used some type of element, whatever that may be, whether it could have been a sponge or whether it could have been bubble wrap or something of that nature, to create that sound and put it under a low pass filter to get that submersion feel. And it made it seem like the scene, well, of course, it's called the subway tunnel track. So, I mean, it makes sense because, you know, subway, and, you know, you get that submerged feel by the low pass filter. But also that sound is, it goes back to another track that's from also the same soundtrack. If you listen to it, it's called 90 Decibels, I believe, which is actually the theme, I guess, of these monsters. And so it really gives this feeling of uneasy, it's just almost like you're scratching your fingers on a chalkboard. But it can really go into essentially being what these monsters sound like, which is interesting because that assignment doesn't usually fall on the composer. It usually falls on the sound designer. But this score really plays into that and uses that sound. Maybe it was made by a sound designer and they just decided to put in the score. But to kind of get into the orchestral parts of it, I thought was very interesting about this score is how it uses the orchestra, the strings, particularly whether they're using the tremolo. For those of you that don't know, tremolo is just basically a shaking of the bow the string players use to get this fuzzy sound. Like, you can hear it underneath everything. And what's really cool about these reviews, I hope we get into it in the future, is we can kind of get into the deeper listening aspect of film music and really honing in on certain sounds. But anyway, going into the string section, you can hear that tremolo underneath all the other aspects of the orchestra. Obviously, you hear the bass playing the main line that makes it sound evil, and, you know, the typical Hollywood orchestra like thing. But that is what the tremolo underneath, it doesn't sound like a typical tremolo you would hear from like your standard avant-garde or golden era Hollywood films like Vertigo or the old Hollywood films where they would use tremolo in that evil way. But here you can hear like a mixture of synth, and obviously there's a lot of synth elements going on here in this soundtrack. But you really can hear the mixture, or at least to me, it sounds like a mixture of whether it's synth 32nd note or I don't think it's a 16th note because it's really, really fast. But it really blends together and it meshes, and you can kind of hear that everything else rolling on top of that. In terms of the score overall storytelling, I think that it does it very well. Of course, you know, all this music is only to serve a purpose of the film, and so you can't really judge it too much based upon the music by itself. I mean, if it worked for the film, it worked for the film. And also, you know, you have to consider the director's perspective and what they want. But for me, one of the things I always consider when listening to film music is I always consider can the music stand on its own? And I think that's one of the things that the great composers do exceptionally well. Like you think about Hans Zimmer, everybody knows him. John Williams, JNH, I'm blanking out on his name, James Newton Howard, the great composers, what they do well is their music is able to stand on their own. And so they make these soundtracks and people literally listen to just the soundtracks because of the music. And Howard Shore is another example of that. So in my personal opinion, I don't think this score has the ability to really stand up on itself on its own. I'm hearing a lot of very typical Hollywood film music things that, you know, would kind of put it in that box of, you know, this is, you know, like other Hollywood films that if there's nothing that was crazy unique about it. But that being said, it was still a great score. And I think it served its purpose very, very well. I mean, especially with a horror film, there's only so much you can do. You don't want to be ruining the elements of the horror, right? So right now we're working on a horror film, and that's one of the things we're talking about with our composer as well. So it's just something to consider when you're listening to these scores and you're like, you know, this doesn't sound interesting. Obviously, I know a lot of the people in the classical community have their opinions about film music. But, you know, maybe we should have a stream about that or a conversation about that. But yeah, this is what I wanted to do, a review over the score. Overall, I think you should definitely listen to the whole score. If I had to rate it on a scale of 1 to 10, I would rate this score a solid 6, in my opinion. And again, none of this is a reflection of the composer's ability, because a lot of times the composers can do a lot more than what they're actually doing. But again, you know, directors have their opinions and they have their perceptions of what they want. So that's just something to consider. But yeah, I think overall it's a very solid score. I think everybody who has the opportunity should definitely listen to it and get into it. A Quiet Place Day One by Alexis Grappas. Hopefully I'm saying that right. But next week, I really want to get into the Twister score, I believe Twister is coming out this weekend. So it's a hot topic. So yeah, hopefully we'll get into reviewing that score. We'll see you the next time on the channel. And if you have any suggestions on how I can do it better, please let me know in the comments, and we'll see you next time.